we're here on site at Infinity Industrial Controls, and we're going to be doing a quick interview with our oldest and one of our most brilliant electrical engineers, Robert James, Bobby. He is an in-demand guy, and when things go bad, that's the guy everyone asks for. So, welcome, Bobby.
Thanks.
Yeah. So, Bobby, when you go out on site and you show up for an emergency service call, what's the first thing you do when you walk up to a machine that you've never seen before?
First thing I do when before I walk up to the machine, I try to get some information from the operator.
Like, did it fault out or there was problems?
How does it normally run and what's it not doing or what is it doing?
Yeah.
Plus it's good to know what they've done to the machine as a service solution before they call me.
Right.
Especially if they've been at it for quite a while, then I have to look for
other problems, right?
created problems on top of it.
Yeah. Yeah. So that requires, for you guys out there, requires that he go through a certain number of steps to determine if the machine has one problem or two problems, right?
Right.
Okay, good. Good. So after you determine, you have some idea of what might be wrong with it, what do you test first?
That depends on how operational the machine is. I mean, if it's dead, no control power on, obviously I have to start at the power section and work through that. A lot of times that'll be, if it's control power's down, there'll be many parts of the machine's field devices and operators are all branched off that single power supply, and there could be a short or something in there, and many times it is, and that'll be what's because the modern power supplies now are kind of protect themselves, so they'll actually shut down before they'll burn up.
Right.
So if there's a fault in the field devices, sometimes the power supplies just shut down. That's
right.
Too much.
Right.
So then in that case, we have to go through and disconnect things one at a time and see what magically comes back.
Yeah. Would you say that it's and I know this just from doing invoices and helping troubleshoot here and there. But would you say that three of the most likely items to go down are relays, contactors, and breakers? Would you say that's pretty true? Those are the trouble sources?
Yeah, probably. But the electromechanical devices, relays, you have motion and electrical contact. Degradation from the many times they don't in devices that are connected to those things often are affected by that, especially if they don't put in voltage snubbers protection devices on them that should be there and they're not.
Well, good. Well, thank you, Bobby. One of the things we want to do as a next video for this, so stay tuned, is to learn how to protect your machinery so that this doesn't happen.